Hi, I'm Randy Robison. Welcome to Life Today TV, Digital Edition. I am here with Francis Chan. And for those of you who know and love him, you are as excited as I am. His latest book is called Letters to the Church. And man, it is so good to talk to you again. I'm sure you don't remember our last interview because it's all a blur. But I remember it because I was like, that guy gets it. Hmm. That guy knows Jesus. He understands, I think, the heart of Christ. And I'm not trying to puff you up or anything. Yeah. But there's something different, something refreshing about your message. Hmm. What do you think that is?
Wow. What do I think it is? That's really hard to say, you know, like, because you have your own experience, right? For me, here's what I think it is. I think I'm pretty simple-minded. Mm. And so I just kind of read through this book and go, I think this is what it says, you know, and then I try to do it. Mm-hmm. And I've tried to, you know, I so admire scholars and people that can think so deeply, and I try to hang with that world, and I just can't. I just kind of go, gosh, this is what I see. It seems simple, and it seems like there are probably more people like me than I realize that are just reading a simple message and seeing it a certain way and just trying to figure out how to do it.
I think you're onto something, because Jesus dropped right in the middle of a bunch of scholars and great legal minds, and they understood the complexities of the law. And he said, just two things you need to worry about.
Yeah.
You know, so there's something to it. What are you trying to communicate in letters to the church? Because you obviously feel called to speak to the body of Christ.
Mm. Yeah. Well, I mean, I see in Scripture, like, I've got to be devoted to the bride. Mm. Like, I believe this is the institution. This is what God is creating. And it's this body, and it's our oneness that's supposed to impact the world. Mm. So if you love Jesus, you have to love the church. And you have to be devoted to the church. And there's a way I think we need to address some of the incongruencies with what we see in the New Testament to what we see today in the church, mm-hmm. and yet do it in a loving way. Mm. And that's what I'm trying to do in the book.
That's key. And that's another thing I noticed about you, is you say a lot of the same things that you might hear somewhere else, but the love that you seem to carry, it just speaks differently. Let me ask you a question, a basic question. How do you define the church?
I believe the church, I mean, the church is those who have truly given their lives to Jesus Christ, trust Him for their salvation, and they are sealed with the Holy Spirit. And so when you say the church, you know, those of us who believe, we're all a part of that bride, the church.
It's people, not institutions.
Absolutely. But, you know, I think too many people have define the church as a building that they go to for an hour, when what Christ wanted was something so much deeper of His followers.
Like what?
Well, in the book I talk about it would resemble more of a gang than it does a church service.
I like that chapter, right?
I mean, isn't that true though? We're saved into a body, like into a people group. Mm-hmm. You're supposed to be 24/7. Mm-hmm. You know, I minister to a lot of people who have come out of the gangs or are still in the gangs, mm-hmm. and man, that is their family, that's their identity, mm-hmm. and there's a sense in which they literally will die for each other. Mm-hmm. I know people who are doing life terms in prison for someone else, mm-hmm. that was a part of that gang, mm-hmm. and that type of relationship, I mean, Christ calls us to something even deeper than that. Mm. And so when I look at what most people consider as going to church, which to me doesn't even make sense, I don't even see it as a biblical statement, mm-hmm. I just go, gosh, it's such a far cry from the intimacy, unity, oneness that Christ wanted for us.
What did you pick up maybe as you traveled and lived overseas for a while?
Yeah. I picked up a lot. I picked up that what we have here in America is very strange. Okay, right? Yeah, I mean, you've been all around the world.
I'm laughing because I know.
Yeah, and they laugh when they hear about some of the things that we do. And then I'm going, why are they laughing so hard? And go, yeah, that is really goofy when you think about it in their context or in context of scripture. And I see a depth of relationship and commitment. And sometimes it's forced, right? In some of these places, if you decide to follow Jesus,
right,
there's a serious right cost to it. So it's not like a casual decision like, yeah, I think I'll follow Jesus. I think I'll get baptized or call myself Christian or pray a prayer when there's not really a cost involved.
Right.
For them, there's a deep, deep cost, and yet they're saying Christ is absolutely worth it.
Mm. So, what's your sort of your message? What do you think you're calling? If there's like, you know, I know that's probably, you say you're simple, so let's try to make it simple.
Okay, what, right? Yeah. It's kind of like when I wrote Crazy Love 10-some years ago. Mm-hmm. And I'm reading about what Christ calls Christians,
right,
you know, to be and how to live, and going, doesn't it seem like a lot more than praying a prayer, you know? And so many people looked on and go, this is what I've always thought. In the same way, what I'm saying is when you read the scriptures about what he calls the church to be, doesn't it seem just way beyond what we're experiencing today
right
and even aiming for today? And where many of us read and go, oh, I wish I could have been a part of that. I'm saying we can. It can happen right now. It's not going to be easy, but that is absolutely possible today.
So. Was there any one verse or passage that you hit and you went, wait a minute, it's not the way I thought it was? Was there any kind of aha moment, or has this always been just sort of part of your journey, part of your struggle, part of your question?
Yeah, I think it all goes
all
together.
Just,
I don't know if there was one verse. I mean, I will say, I mean, it's a verse that's over and over and over and over and over again. The New Testament is loving one another deeply from the heart, loving one another just as Christ loved us.
Yeah.
Like, it was all of the one another's. Mm. You know, I forget how many there are in Scripture. I mean, just all of the times that he wanted a deep, like if you and I were really going to be the church, then I should have such a deep, deep love. I am called to love you just as Christ loved me.
Mm-hmm.
That's another level.
It's
one thing to sit here and go, oh yeah, we get along. We're, you know, it's quite another thing to say, I would go to the cross for you.
Mm-hmm.
And Christ says, when the Holy Spirit, you know, who wants that of you, empowers you to do that, and you start doing that with one another, then the world's going to know that the Father sent me.
Yeah.
And I go, wow, I've never even thought about pursuing that much unity with my brothers and sisters in Christ.
But you have been now for a while.
Now I am. But for years, that wasn't even the goal. And I'm like, how did I miss that? It's not like one verse.
Right,
it's like
every
page, right?
Right?
And so I just, it's just, that's kind of what the book was these are not little vague, obscure thoughts.
Yeah.
It's just, I don't know how you can get anything different
from
this book.
Yeah.
But sometimes we just follow a pattern and what's laid out before us, right?
Yeah.
And we try to tweak it a little bit. And fortunately, I've been able to just kind of start over, you know, the blank piece of paper and go, gosh, this is really seems like what he wanted of his body, the church.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you for that message. Do you still have a website where you've got some materials?
Yeah, if you go to We Are Church.
We Are Church.
WeArechurch.com. Yeah.
Great. Go to the website, check it out, pick up Letters to the Church. It's not to a building down the street. It's to you, the believer. And check out Francis Chan when he's on Life Today. You can see more of him on our broadcast program that's available at lifetoday.org. Thank you for watching and sharing this interview. Be sure to check out the social media for Life Today Television, and you can connect with me on Facebook and Twitter. And if you haven't already subscribed or followed this channel, do it now so you can see more of our great guests.